Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the stream. As for how long I'm going to be streaming, well, that's up for debate, because I am ill today. Not feeling too bad right now, but, you know, we'll see how things go. But yes, we shall carry on with some Red Dead.
Hello.
Oh, hi, Kieran.
Ah, you again. Where's my money? Where is it?
What do you mean?
How much longer is he going to fall for that, I wonder? As you can see, Arthur has changed his duds yet again, now that I've got a fancy new batch of feathers to shove into his hat. But, yeah, I was thinking, at least for the moment, we'll see what Dutch wants. And then after that, I think I might dodge around and do a few... Oh, one thing I need to do is I need to pay off my bounty. So you see, I kind of poached an ox to make some fancy new duds at the trapper, and a fella didn't like me doing that, so I sort of kind of shot him in the head. So yeah, I kind of have a bit of a bounty up here now. I'll have to deal with that later. But yeah, I was thinking we'll go see what Dutch wants, and then maybe we'll do some exploring around and hunting and fishing and all that jazz. Just a nice relaxing exploration kind of thing that's probably going to end in bloodshed regardless. We'll see. But first and foremost, let's see what Mr. Vandalin wants from us. He's been trying to get my attention for quite some time now. Also, he looks pretty... You look pretty down the dumps, Dutch. You got kind of a hangdog expression on your face. How you doing?
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more,
he's glowing.
Too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
I'm going to take that as a compliment, Dutch.
Hello, gentlemen.
Arthur.
Alright.
Hi, Charles. All We're right. going to ride again.
Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Now you, Micah, you can go to hell.
Hey, Arthur.
So, you're still alive?
Of course.
If I want to wantonly murder half the town, then I'll take you with me. For the moment, however, I'll take Charles. He's apparently riding bareback. Good for him. If I remember correctly, I believe Trelawney.
Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's a strange one.
I mean, a little bit.
He's just a cockroach in fancy britches. But he gets into nooks and crannies the rest of us can't. We just need to find him before he scurries off again.
I believe he said he was staying in the shanty town just outside of Rhodes, so I guess that's where we're going. Trelawney, this sort of member of Dutch Vanderlyn's gang. Also, I like how, you know, Charles was saying everyone seems pretty fine in the new camp when, shortly before I started streaming, I witnessed a fight between Susan and Karen. I believe Karen, Susan slapped the shit out of Karen because she was drunk. And Dutch is talking about how much this place is a swamp-infested, a swampy-infested shithole. Shithole, yes, there we go. I might want to,
Reckon it's that one with the fire outside.
Let's take a look.
What a nasty-looking hovel you're living in, Mr. Trelawney.
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house. Shit. This don't look so good.
Well, why are you pushing me out of the way?
Here, so where is he?
Let's take a look around.
Inspect the clue!
This food's barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
Spread out and search for clues, gang.
Bed's not made, so he must have been here recently.
You see anything there?
Tacitus Kilgore Mining Company certificate. Tacitus Kilgore Mining Company. This is to certify that blank is the holder of blank shares inclusive in the above company, subject to the provisions of the memorandum and articles of association thereof. Don't rush me, Charles. And the sum of $1 has been paid to each of the said shares. Okay.
Found anything?
Would you relax? You're standing right next to what looks like a clue.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look. Tracks. Come on.
There's some blood here. That ain't good.
Yep.
What are you doing? Let's go.
Oh, you know, I was just getting shat upon by my horse.
Down the path here. What's your tracking these days?
All right.
Middling to poor.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see. Trelawney's staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
I presume this is what I'm tracking. I'm not actually following that horse, am I?
You know.
Nope.
When me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
See? They must have crossed over the tracks. Huh. They seem to head into the forest now.
Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say.
Arthur, where are you going?
Just riding into you. And your weird Dalmatian horse.
Excuse me.
Howdy, fella.
Yeah.
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one. Yeah.
All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here!
Come here!
Nah!
At least hit me properly.
Quit the sucker punch there, my friend. First, I'll rob your friend. $22. Not bad. Hello, friend. Would you like a crushed larynx?
Where is Trelawney?
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
Nah, you.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, okay. For Christ's sake, they took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Okay.
Let me see you again, you hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
What do you mean? Are you talking to me or are you talking to him?
Let's go.
Also, like how that was an honor thing, despite the fact I just beat
Follow
the shit out of him a little bit.
I think there's a way around, so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Oh, I suppose I did kill him. I could have killed him.
I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
Careful! You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal, just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line.
Including us. Have I been here before? I don't know if I've been here before or not. No, I haven't, actually. This is, just inside of the Braithwaite property. Oh, actually, it looks like there's a little cabin down there, too. I have not actually been south of the Braithwaite property. It looks like there's a cabin there, and it looks like there's a spot there. So that might be a couple of other things for me to check out at some point or another. Providing these aren't one of the areas we're going to right now, which is entirely possible. Also, if this is so close to Braithwaite property, I'm surprised there aren't any guards out around this way.
Must be it. Whoa.
Oh, let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that sack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen.
Ma, you have a nice hat.
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Okay, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Who knows what he told them? Let's get after those sons of bitches.
They've gone into the cornfields. We need to flush them out. Did you see those birds?
Hello, my friend. Also, I have a neat little, well, I can't say little, I suppose. I have some explosive rounds for my revolvers now.
Where the hell are...
But you know what? There's one! Hello, my friend. Goodbye, my friend. Although, to be honest, the last one, maybe I should pound the tar out of him and try to question him.
Can't have gone far.
All tied up in a neat little sack, too, at that. Ah!
He's mine! Let me take him. You get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet.
Nice shot.
Come on.
You should have taken the money.
No. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you. Gunshots are...
I wonder, can I shoot the man's head off and take it?
The gunshots are coming from that barn! Come on!
Nah, it's not a fancy hat. Or rather, not a good hat, anyway.
I got you now!
Ah, Miles.
There he is! Take him out!
Boom!
Good. You should be the last of them.
That was needlessly cruel, but okay.
Alright, let's go back for Trelawney.
Ooh.
You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery feller.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought.
He has a rare rolling block rifle.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right.
Okay, so what exactly makes that rolling block rifle so rare? A rare rolling block rifle made of light wood and blackened steel, adorned with carvings previously belonging to a bounty hunter after Josiah Trelawney and found in a barn near Braithwaite Manor. This gun is a single-shot weapon and can use regular... Okay, so it's not really... Well, how much better is it than the other one? Whatever. I'll take it anyway. It's always good to have fancy weaponry. Fancy weaponry for a fancy man. Fancy murderous man who blows people's heads off with explosive rounds. Well, if I don't head immediately
Mr.
back to camp.
Boy.
Well, at least he didn't run off.
Well, he's still here, at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
Suppose he was just beaten.
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunter. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
So we have a new visitor at camp. Ah, dear old friend Trelawney.
There always seems to be more and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it, but well, even that ain't the way I remember it.
Well, my beard grew in pretty quick. Killed two bounty hunters in the cornfields within 1 minute. Oh well. Damn shame there's no barber in town here. It would be rather nice if there were. Oh hey, new paper. Also, I may sell some things. I could attempt to steal stuff there, but I don't know. I'm trying not to cause too much crap in roads while I'm here. Now, is there anything I can do to upgrade that rolling block rifle, I wonder?
Nice to see you again, partner. What can I offer you?
Let's have a look.
So what can I buy in terms of ammunition? There's not really much I cannot. Well, no, I might want some arrows.
All right.
I seem to be constantly running low on arrows, so I'm just able to get some more.
Oh, I'm real excited to try this.
Nah, it doesn't look like it. Well, the special rolling block rifle, probably I can't customize in any regard. Makes sense, it's kind of customized itself.
Thank you.
Howdy, boy! What's all the news?
In need of a good story?
Not doing,
thank you for your business.
Much of a job hawking these. Wait, did I just buy that? Wait. Notes, handbills, photographs, treasure maps. I still need to track down more treasure afterwards too. Cigarette cards, newspapers. Saint Denis Times number 46. I guess that could be the only one I got. Prisoner escapes, murderer was set to hang, score of lawmen. That was me breaking out that asshole. You know, that guy. Micah! Statue of General Quincy Harris was defaced in a craven act, the hero of the War of Northern Aggression. Saw his bravest men cut down in front of his eyes at the Battle of Scarlet Meadows. The word coward appeared on the statue, no doubt placed there by a handful of ill-advised citizens who seek to tarnish the name of a general that historians agree was a courageous military man. Yeah. Cromwell orders fast steamship. Henry Jenkins was a veteran of the force. Lawman found dead. Okay, that's a guy in Saint Denis, somebody I haven't checked. Fifth person slain, pattern identified, message scrawled in blood, worries intensify plague, similar to deaths years ago. Residents of Saint Denis are living in fear as the ritualistic deaths from some years ago have returned. The pattern is the same. Teeth marks like those of a hyena or dog on the body are noticeable. There are messages scrawled next to the body in blood. Some have had attributed the deaths to yellow fever, but others cite vampires as the cause. Saint Denis lawmen announced years ago they had caught the culprit and indeed did hang Bosco Lopez, who had spent many years living in Argentina before arriving in Saint Denis by frigate. Now that the fifth victim has been found, lawmen are expressing caution, indicating that all residents should avoid traveling alone in the evening wherever possible, and keep all residences without locks barricaded overnight. Women are especially advised to show caution, as they are more often than not the victims of the attacks. So there's a vampire. The King of Corsets! They have fled. Lemoyne Raiders now in Texas. The ex-soldiers, renegades, and criminals that loosely comprise the Lemoyne Raiders militia have mostly fled to Texas after repeated clashes with the government's law enforcement. Reaching the Free Stater anti-government and anti-tax doctrine, their message soon grew tiresome for a populace that simply wants to move on after the war between the states. The scrappy militia has spent the last few years robbing government employees and institutions and regular civilians as well. After some stinging defeats, the Lemoyne Raiders fled to areas of Texas, where it is reported their disdain for paying tax or supporting their government is more readily received. That seems like a lie, because I know there's a bunch of them here somewhere. There's a massive cliff face sculpture in the Grizzlies, huh? War brewing in Europe. Oh yeah, that's the whole thing with the British trying to take out the Dutch settlers in Africa. Yeah, that was kind of nasty. Women should keep silence, allowed to sing but not speak in church. She is subordinate to man, oh dear. She may sing and mix sex devotional services or in meetings of her own sex. The report was signed by all five clergymen, as they remain unanimous on the woman question. As does this newspaper, which supports the natural order of things, even though we are men of science first and foremost. Sure. New railroad completed. Okay, I think that might be the one I helped out. Anyway, that's enough reading the news.
Back again. Howdy. Have a look. All for sale, except the floorboards. All right, but if it has feathers or fur, keep it in the bag. Sure, hand it over. Yep, I'll buy that.
Just want to sell a bunch of random things here. Oh, I can't actually sell any of the bitters and stuff that I make. Probably I can sell them to a doctor, but there aren't any doctors in town.
Morning to you.
Just like last
Good
month.
Morning to you.
Hi, folks.
Morning.
For a minute, I was pretty certain that man was not wearing any pants. Peter Pantsless. Yes.
Hey, partner.
Morning, friend.
Oh, I was gonna have a chat with the butcher. There's something I need to see.
What's it to be?
Yeah, I don't really have anything I want to sell to you. However, yeah, I was kind of hoping that I'd be able to just straight up buy animal fat. But it seems like I'm probably just going to need to hunt stuff I can get animal fat off of to make myself some more explosive rounds. Which means there's going to have to be a culling of pigs. I shall have to destroy the swine wherever so I find them. Oh boy, Micah has something he wants me to do. I think I'd sooner go talk to Trelawney. Although first and foremost, let's go see if we can catch that bluegill. Hopefully not run afoul of any beasties out in the woods. When I was out hunting for birds to make, you know, this fancy feathered hat that I have, or at the very least add fancy feathers to my pre-existing hat, I almost ran afoul of a cougar, but fortunately it murdered somebody else by the river and then ran away. And I managed to avoid its ire, thank God. That said, I kinda need to go hunt for cougars at some point or another. Now, I don't really know where this legendary bluegill is. It's here somewhere. That might be it over there. I don't know, we'll find out now. Let's do a little bit of fishing. I need a special lake lure. I'll try a few casts. If I can't catch it within that, I'll probably just leave it be and come back for it later.
Oh, I got you. I got you.
Come here, you slippery devil! You must go into my fry pan! Well, not really. You need to be mailed to that dong Jimmy Gill and then be stuffed and mounted. Oh, it looks like a big one, though. I think that might actually be him.
Don't fight too much.
Accept your fate. Ooh, you look like a big one.
You're magnificent.
I think that's it. Yep. Large-sized bluegill can grow to 12 inches.
Bluegill. Nice.
The legendary bluegill has been spotted by fishermen around Scarlet Meadows. It is rumored that this fish can only be attracted by using special lake lures. Sightings of this fish have increased during rainy weather. The size of this bluegill is rumored to be over 19 inches long and weighing around 4 pounds. Pretty damn big for a bluegill. Let's send this gill to Mr. Gill, then. Apparently not too big that it can't fit in my bag. Maybe that was because I was fishing for it over there where me and Kieran set up shop. So maybe that was the problem, I was just fishing for it at the wrong spot. No, I think that's Braithwaite property. Yeah, it is. Alright, let's rod back in the roads and mail this fish. And watch as the fine lads in the postal service hate me for sending something so stinky. Also, I found another dinosaur bone while I was bird hunting, so I'll have to send that location to Madame Deborah. It's weird, you know? Like, it takes so long for me to find a lot of the cigarette cards, not so much, because those are a bit easier to track down, but there's so goddamn many of them! Dinosaur bones and dream catchers and rock carvings and stuff, though, there aren't as many of those, but holy crap are they hard to find. Wait, what am I doing? I actually need to go to the train station. Ah! Ah! I don't know what kind of trick that was, but it was a pretty bad one. Oh well. What's yours is mine. Can't let that stuff go to waste. Seeing as how I just nearly impaled my horse on an outhouse, I need money for its medical bills. Where the hell is the train station? Over here. Okay. I swear one day I am going to brutally murder that poor horse, and I'm gonna feel so bad about it.
Hey, mister.
Hey.
Speaking of, maybe I should give her a little clean down and actually feed her. Because I believe she's probably in pretty rough shape.
Take it easy.
Take it easy, it's only a little severe trauma, you'll be fine.
Hey, fellas. Well, hello. Hey, mister. Hey there. Hey there.
There we go, being nice to people just, you know, made up for me robbing the dead.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello there.
How do you do, sir?
Oh. Oh, there.
Been a while since you were around this way.
Partner?
Bitchin' chops. Oh, also, I should probably pay off that bounty I have.
I thought you were sweating a little.
Just to be honest, it was all a big misunderstanding.
All right, what would you like to send?
Oh, I've actually got another one that I haven't sent yet. Okay, then.
All right, we'll take care of it.
Have them all shook her up.
Farewell.
You look like a man on a mission.
Mm-hmm. That's a damn fine hat, lady.
Ma'am?
Why, hello there, sir.
It's like she's got a whole bird on her head.
Well, now.
So, don't let me keep you.
See you soon.
Hello, mister.
Hello there.
Howdy, fellas.
These fellows are making me feel a bit, emasculated. I think I might have to grow out some impressive facial hair of my own. Do I have any hair tonic? Lockbreaker, which I've never used and don't really know how to use. There we go, let's down some of this stuff. The beard must grow! The hair must flow! Arthur needs to be luxurious!
Easy there, girl.
Alright, before I go off on a little exploration mission, I think I'll go down and see what Trelawney wants. Hell with Micah. I'll deal with him when I come back. Violently, I would hope. Sadly, probably not. But yeah, I think after that I'll, probably hunt the legendary fox, and then I might explore the grizzlies a little bit. There's whole sections of that place I haven't seen yet. And I don't know if the game is ever going to take me up there. I mean, it might, but I haven't seen it happen yet. Seems like I'm just going to be going further towards Saint Denis if I go anywhere. Arthur.
Are you busy, Arthur?
Depends, what do you want? I see you cleaned up nice afterwards. I'm not surprised. Wait, what? I see he's pretty big on magic tricks, this fella. That's amazing! Arthur just stares at him, dumbfounded. How you do that?
Why?
Well, I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
Kind of are.
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. I would have even thought. Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed men attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot. So where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes!
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out.
Yeah, you know, the place where you were just kidnapped and beaten?
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I'd done my part. Each to their strengths, dear boy. You know, you boys should really watch yourselves with those two families. This is a small town. People talk. I tried to mention it to Josiah, but you know how he is. Anyway,
While they're off chasing their pot of Confederate gold hidden at the end of some rainbow, let me present you with something real.
So, where exactly are we going?
The train station. The clerk there, Alden, is quite a fellow. Very informed on the comings and goings of coaches around these parts.
Ah, I see.
And nothing at all can horribly go wrong, I'm certain. Run, rabbit! Run! Oh dear, I seem to be dropping frames again. Not sure what's going on with that, but okay, hopefully it levels out. Out of the way, you fool!
Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur.
Oh, that's good. I ain't exactly much for words. Except for when I am. Arthur's very selective with that kind of thing.
Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off.
So I can't even talk to that guy? Shame. Wait, are we gonna go talk to the guy who kept calling me an awful person? I believe we are, yes.
Money to be made on the new railroad, for those who know.
Hello, Alden.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Remember me and all those people I murdered?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay, well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it. Discouraged men. I like that.
Well, no doubt he does.
Should I say adieu?
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
Yeah, whatever.
What the hell?
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me.
Also, why can I not just see that thing I just got? And Bill's notes. Okay, whatever, I guess it mustn't be that important if it won't let me read it.
Okay, let's go. This way.
Oh, this ain't good.
It was nice to see that fellow just up and fell over again. Jesus, Trelawney. Watch out. We're supposed to keep
what
a low profile here.
Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance, the unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble, you gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
Because of course he does.
Wrong, let's meet back here at this crossroad, okay?
All right.
But of course I've been back and forth to Strawberry several times since we murdered half the town.
Here we are. This is the spot. Okay. This should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. What were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strongbox, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strongbox, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strongbox without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson. Oh, very good, Alden, very good. Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon.
So this is where they teach me how to use the lockbreaker, finally?
There it is, right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once. I'll ride ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing.
What's happening? What is he doing?
I hope you don't mind my singing.
Not at all.
I'm prepared. Show.
It's a free country.
Did you say a show?
It's a small benefit to build an opera. Blackwater. Just...
Mrs. Chester Damson.
Oh my god.
I flattered, buddy.
Stop the coach, my good man! Stop the coach!
Whoa! Miss Dempsey, why?
Whoa, he...
Stop singing.
Your audience, they were rather cruel.
New Yorkers are pretty... and fools who believe Westerners don't know anything about culture.
I couldn't agree more.
You can't see me. You can just see that magnificent horse.
Would you see something for me? I'm looking for a mezzo soprano.
I don't know.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth.
She as well has a hat that looks like a dead bird.
Oh,
Thank you.
Non lasciare per dire.
Adagio, molto adagio.
Nei frito.
Madam, we should move the road to that safe.
Did I just only get $5 though?
Can we go, please? I got a train to catch.
Madam, I've heard enough. Might I have your card? The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough about Mrs. Damson. Magnifico. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell.
I mean, it was the easiest $5 I've ever made, but it was still only $5 as far as I can tell.
You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy, teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, it's only good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Well, in reality, maybe it was more than $5, I don't know. Oh, wait, no, the total take was like 750. Okay, then. Never mind. Complete within 8 minutes and 10 seconds. Okay, then. And that was enough to finish off that part of the bandit. I have to rob 4 stores in one day. I gotta cause one crazy amount of hell then. I wonder where the best place to do that is. Saint Denis might be the best place to do that. To be honest. I gotta bust out somebody in Saint Denis with the gambler challenge anyway. And I gotta go to Saint Denis from Strawberry in 9 minutes. I have to kill 6 animals with a reload or switch. I'm gonna need to find some birds to do that, I'd say a whole pile of them. I don't know how to craft dynamite arrow, and I don't know how to craft any shotgun ammo. Okay, whatever. Well, anyway, now that we've taken care of that, and seeing as how we're so close to where it is anyway, let's go hunting for a legendary fox. And then after that I'll ride up north and sell that to my good friend the trapper. Oh, snake. Snake! Dun, 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 dun. Now before I go gunning for this fox, though, what is it that takes a fox out real easy? I think it might be either a bow and arrow or a repeater or something. Kitten. I am not hunting kittens. Well, eventually I'm going to hunt the big kitten, but that's about it. It's coyote. Donkey. Nah, it seems like a repeater or a bow and arrow, so.
Hey.
Okay, so let's take that out. Maybe poison arrows just to make out. Fire arrows! Burn the place! Burn it down! All of it! Fire is my friend. It's making all the angry grunting noises. Swear to God, if I run into a bear here, there aren't supposed to be any bears in this area. What killed this? Well, I mean, waste not, want not, I guess, but what killed us? Is there a cougar in here I'm not aware of? That'd be quite the pain in the hole, wouldn't it? Hunt for fox, get cougar. Okay, let's try this again. Run through the underbrush, make a wicked racket, scare away the legendary fox. Of course, that being said, to make things at least a little bit easier, I should probably do this. I think that might be it over there, actually. Also, what's this? A chanterelle. No, I believe those are just turkeys. How I can confuse a fox with a turkey is beyond me, but you know. Pick some sage while I'm at it. I do need to make sage-related things for another challenge. Also, how are my weapons holding up? Well, I mean, that repeater hasn't been used in God knows how long, so it should be in relatively decent shape. What have we here? Wait, what? Oh, it's right there. Doy. Walked right over it. Dung!
Okay. A trail. I better get moving.
How frequently must I root in shit? Very. The answer is very.
Don't seem close.
It's a pretty small area, though, Arthur. I don't imagine that. Okay, this is its track. But... wait. Yeah, this is the thing's trail, but where is it? Where does it go? It just stops right here. Do I just have to keep going that way and maybe run into it? Aha, there we go.
Getting close.
Warmer? Warmer? Warm like the blood I shall soon spill. Oh, there you are. Let the poison do its work. All will be over soon. Oh no. Oh. I am very sorry, boy. Maybe I shouldn't have used the poison arrow. I don't think it was all that. And I shot the poor thing in the eye. Jeez.
That's it.
I feel really bad every time I kill one of these legendary animals. Although that, actually, to get total progress, I think I need to skin the thing rather than just pick it up and bring it to the trapper, so... I'm sorry, boy. On, I think that's the only way I can get his claw, too. Why must I hurt so many animals? What's wrong with me? Oh yes, I like to look pretty, that's what's wrong with me. Alright then, Beira. Let's ride on up and say hello to the trapper. Along the way, I think I might stop in and see my good friend Seamus sell off some stuff that I got.
Yeah.
Good old dullard Seamus, whom I quote-unquote accidentally shot in the head with a shotgun that one time. He got better, which is pretty impressive considering he didn't have a head to speak of after I was done. And he was glitched out to the point where he kind of had floaty bits for a while. Maybe I should have shot one of those pigs, one of those boars. That way I would have gotten more animal fat, but oh well. I'll pass. I don't recall seeing this before. I would half expect there was something here, but maybe not. I don't know, maybe one of the legendary fish is in this area, who knows. Lots of gators. All the more reason I shouldn't linger for too long.
Okay then, girl. Yeah.
I want to be grabbed and mauled in some form of death roll. Some sort of deadly death roll. TM. Yeah. Maybe when I'm up exploring the grizzlies, I'll find this giant rock carving they were talking about. See, because the area of the grizzlies you start in is only really the half of it. Which I still get the feeling I haven't explored that area entirely well either. There's probably a bunch of stuff I've missed.
Yeah.
Also, next time I illegally acquire a horse, I'm gonna have to bring it over to those two weird fellows. we were dealing with after the Braithwaite incident. Hi, Seamus. I have some things to sell, and maybe you can make a trinket for me.
Come on, I'm not staying open, not with Wagner around.
Also, I found a bunch of gold teeth. I found them in a dead man's saddlebag. I don't know what he was doing with them. I'll sell all those because I can make a bunch and that should help with the herbalist challenge I've got. Sell one of these. Keep the other because, again, that was a gift. Ooh, I got a lot of pocket watches, though. Sell those. And some salmon. And a gold nugget. Okay.
Been a while since you were through here. Go on, have yourself a quick nosy.
I can apparently craft volatile dynamite, but I don't really know how. I can make incendiary buckshot, but I also don't know how. I gotta check that. I probably need animal fat for that. I should start making that then so I can get that other challenge. I don't know how to make dynamite arrows, though. Interesting. Maybe that's a thing I can only do, after a mission.
Looking to get something put together, huh?
Buckslaw! What does this do? Permanently increases the time that Eagle Eye can stay active by 5 seconds. That's useful.
Better than a rabbit foot.
I don't have any mail yet. I'm expecting to get some at some point or another anyway.
Come on, girl.
This is ride through the storm. There's been a lot of stormy weather lately too, I've noticed. I don't know what the deal with that is. Because I'm impatient, I ride around the train. I feel like I should probably engage in another good old-fashioned train robbery at some point or another too, but I imagine there's going to be a bandit challenge for that regardless, so I can wait.
You good, girl? Easy.
I already seen- yeah, I've already been up to hear this word that, one of the fossils was. The dino bones, which I need to find more of. Let's go see my trapper friend, Bob McKenzie, that's his name, right? That's a good Canadian name. Oh god, wolves. Nope, keep going. Ignore the wolves. I gotta lose them before I go down to the trapper. I remember I killed a wolf to save the two of us at one point, and then he ended up informing the law on me. Disturbing the peace, he called it. Sorry, lads.
No.
What's happening here?
Oh, no.
You're okay. You're all
Okay, they're gone.
Run! As fast as you can! Get away from me!
What? What just happened? I don't know what just happened. Was I in the right here? I don't know. I mean, I suppose I have to assume I was. Not so much now, on account of the fact that I'm robbing the victims, but... I mean, they're not going to need that 76 cents. If I wasn't busy, I'd probably sell their stagecoach, too. Well, not stagecoach, but you know what I mean. You didn't see nothing.
All right, let's have a look. Boy, the things I can make with this.
The things you are going to make with that.
Sure.
Been a pleasure doing business.
All made to measure.
That thing was the trophy buck? Yeah. I need a perfect elk pelt for that. Well, I can't even really wear that with these. And the legendary fox, buck and fox range gloves. Anyway, I won't bother actually making that right now.
I don't sell to stores. You want my wares right here.
Alas, he doesn't have a fire I can camp at. I'm gonna have to make one of my own camps, I think, for the moment. Get out of this rain. This is not good exploring weather. Sleep. Oh, it's morning. Oh, well, we'll sleep till noon then. Sleep. An easy sleep. What can I create? I don't really need to make any more food. We'll make some more small game arrows. That ought to do. So what is it I need to make the incendiary shotgun? Well, I can't make explosive shotgun slugs. What do you mean recipe not known? I thought it said maybe I need to actually read it before I can do it then? I don't know. I'm already carrying 3 of 3 potent bitters, but I thought I sold so many of them. Nah, I sold potent snake oil is what I sold, never mind. Alright, let's see. Newspaper, journal, books, cigarette, newspapers. Oh, that's newspaper scraps. Excuse me, business cards. Phineas, Jeremy, and Francis. Okay. Recipe pamphlets, there we go. Oh, well there we go. I do need to actually read the damn things. I thought just buying them was enough. Apparently I was mistaken. For carbuncles or other constitutional disturbances, apply a poultice soaked in laudanum before lancing. Special horse reviver. Did you know to treat croup, grind mustard seed and salt, mix with lard and apply to the throat and chest? Ah, this one requires sage. I think I already knew that one. Over scent, potent predator bait, potent herbivore bait, explosive express cartridge. In some areas of the country, it is illegal to call moose by moonlight. Ooh. Fire bottle. Split point cartridge. To waterproof a hat, steep it in salt water. While wet, cover it with a mixture of two parts tar and one part fat that have been boiled together. Small game arrows, improved arrows, fire arrows, horse ointment. Incendiary buckshot. Shotgun shell and moonshine. Huh. Special horse medicine. Poison throwing knife. Horse meal. Yeah, I didn't know a lot of these. The Greeks considered the owl a symbol of protecting armies going to war. Okay, let's try this again then. Aha, there we go, that's some stuff I can make using sage. Though apparently only one. Yeah, I don't really need to make one of those. Now I can make buckshot incendiary. Only one bit though, because I've foolishly sold all my moonshine. Ah, I can use sage to make this. And I think this might be the last thing I need to make using sage. Well, I guess I'll make another one just in case, because I don't think it actually popped up yet. Crafting time with Arthur Morgan. I may as well make the potent horse stimulant too. Go hog wild with it. Not that I ever really use this stuff that much. Aha! I did it! I've unlocked more things. Pick 5 mushrooms and feed them to your horse! Okay then. Fair enough. Oh yes, I was going to drink more hair tonic. I was wondering why I just went into my kit. Bug. Well, let's see about this reinforced equipment. Also, what was that? Not a mushroom. Okay.
Good to see you again.
What do you mean, good to see me? I camped out behind your stall all night.
Hello again. That was quick. Quality hide makes the hardiest clothes.
What do you have for me, boy? Well, I mean, doesn't really look much different than a lot of other stuff I have, so, yeah, whatever. I don't care. I won't get it right now. Okay, so my plan is to head north into Grizzlies and go somewhere. Yeah, I think what I'll do is I'll head on up north this way. I haven't gotten to the top of this hill. Let's go to the top of that hill and take a look around. I'll do that first. I probably can't go too much further north into the mountains, but I'll check it out. Gonna need to dress up in some warmer gear, obviously, but that's why I still have the bear outfit. The bar hunter. Bar. Wait, before I go too far up that way, I have to get myself something else to drink. I shall be back in just a second. Alright, I have returned for exploration. After, well, you know, getting myself a big old glass of water, and because, obviously, this is exactly what you should be drinking when you're sick, a glass of whiskey. The burn shall heal me. It's one called 11 Souls, which is a pretty epic name for a whiskey. Rather mystical, I suppose, is the better way to put it. Epic's a rather stupid thing to call whiskey, to be honest, come to think of it. Mystical. Mystical is also pretty foolish to call whiskey that, but with a name like 11 Souls, I mean, you know, I gotta, even though they're only talking about the number of casks they use for it, nothing really mystical about that. It's like there's a couple of bodies over there. I'm not gonna bother with that. I know what that is. It's the goddamn Mumfreys again. I've had to deal with quite a few of them. Jerks that they are. I don't know how far north I can go. Can I go that way? I don't know. I'm not going to bother exploring that right now, though. My main thing is I want to check out this place up here. Looks like there's a reservation up there. That's interesting. I haven't seen any natives since I suppose it was like three or four guys who were watching us as we first rode into Horseshoe Overlook. They didn't have any beef with us, and we didn't have any beef with them. There, girl. If they did have any beef with us, they probably could have blindsided us without us ever knowing, so. They were probably watching our entire trek down the mountains.
Hey, mister!
I don't know why you fellas are so ornery, but okay. Howdy, fella.
Hi there, mister.
Hey, Yeah, because I'm riding pretty close to the... Well, actually, the flattened cabin isn't the one I was thinking about. It was the that one down there that hasn't been marked at all, but... I gotta see if there was a note I picked up from there, because I think there might have been a bizarre thing that I missed. Oh wait, no, I've seen that one. Dutch of speech, night folks, English. That's a... The clan. Buttered paw. Wedding certificate. Note from Jim. Oh, that's those guys I killed. Oh yeah, yeah, that note. It's my list of debtors. Fuck, wait, okay, maybe it wasn't in that list then. Also, I just heard a bear. Either that or maybe I don't have that note. Nah, it seems very, very likely that... Okay, maybe I didn't actually pick up that note. I'm gonna have to go back down to that cabin later and check it out, because apparently there's a possibility to see a friggin' UFO in this game somehow. And it has to do with that weird, like, suicide ritual cult down in that cabin that I stumbled across at one point. And I'll have to check that out later. Yes, yes, calm down. It'll be fine. Hey look, that's where I killed the bear that I'm currently wearing.
There we go.
What's that?
Yep.
Is that where that guy is curving that face?
Hey, hey!
It is, actually. How the hell did you get up there, buddy? Oh, also he's dead apparently. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, I gotta go check this out. Oh, he hanged himself. Okay then, that's something. It's amazing how many stories in this game end in suicide. That's pretty goddamn depressing. I'll have to see if I can cut him down, I guess. Oh, providing I don't fall off a cliff myself. The crack almost makes it look like there should be something in there. I don't know, maybe he's hidden treasure somewhere. Feel kind of bad for robbing this poor bastard, but you know. It's a damn fine sculpture. Facing cliff. Draw a picture of that, Arthur. Commemorate this man's life. And he even drew the corpse. Because of course he did. Legendary Fox. Howdy, ma'am. It's a mighty fine face you got there. Your body is very cliff-like in nature, though. What's he doing with jewelry? Ow. Ow. Well, let's see if I can cut the man down, I guess. Careful not to fall off the cliff. I don't know what I was expecting. Ah, the hell with it. Let's just use a gun. How very ignoble. Or then again, he might be in rigor. Note from the sculptor. Whoever finds this, I am sorry. I was worthless in life, and now I'm even more so in my death. I gave my life to my art, to creating a monument to the one that I loved, but in doing so I lost her. Great art moves very slowly, but the heart moves very quick. Now I look on her face and I see that terrible French cad, that scribbler, that second-rate smearer of colors, that crude little goat. I have been a fool. I will die next to my monument to foolishness. That's a hell of a story you got there. And sorry it turned out so badly. No. 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 Well, you've claimed one more life, you fool. Dead. May my death be on your head. He's murdered me from the grave. Where's my horse? There you are. Well, this is exactly where I was when I spotted the corpse. Well, not the corpse, but the head. So, you know, it's not that bad, I guess. Could be worse. Something tells me there's a number of hidden things up this way, but I'm gonna have to take the time to actually peck around and look for it. Dream catchers, bones, rock carvings, what have you. Well, rock carvings that aren't that giant face in the cliff. Let's head up this way, actually. Okay. Or maybe I shouldn't have. Oh, crap. Shit. Into the cliffs.
Yep.
Ah! Sorry, girl. Ah, shit. You want to be a hero too, other wolf? That's right, you better run. I'll let you live. Ah, crap. If I can actually get down from here, I'll be sitting pretty. Do I have any mushrooms I can actually feed this thing right now, I wonder? Got beets, celery, corn, apple, pear, peach, burdock root, chanterelle! Have some shrooms. Oh, I could probably, do this now. I can fatten up my horse on, mushrooms. And get my horse high on shrooms. Yes. Feed.
Easy there, girl.
It is delish. Do I have any other form of shroom? I do!
Yeah, that's my girl.
Ta-da! Craft 9 items using Indian tobacco as an ingredient. Okay, then.
Yeah.
So where the hell am I? Okay, yeah. I just kind of, took a shortcut over the cliff, that's all. See how far up I can get, how far north. Here's my scan with Eagle Eye, make sure I'm not missing anything. Hi!
Mister?
Where the harrowing trail of this. I love a view, though. I love a view. Ooh, especially the lake, that's real pretty.
Yeah.
Of course, we have more of a hell of a view right here.
Whoa.
Out! Stop. 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 Don't mind me, just nearly killing myself again. Just going to take my horse along for the ride this time. The horrible last ride we'll ever take.
Hold up.
See, that over yonder strikes me as being just, set dressing. I probably can't go all the way over there. I can almost guarantee I can't go all the way over there. Although there's a trail that goes that way. I don't know. It warrants more investigation. Quite the chasm. Maybe I shouldn't fuck around too much riding around up here. It's entirely possible it may get me killed. Last thing I need is for the horse to get spooked by something and buck me over a cliff. Lots of rams. Wait, what? Why am I wanted dead or alive? That doesn't seem right, does it? And only in this one spot. This tiny patch of land, they want Earth or dead. He's perfectly safe otherwise, but God help him if he gets caught by the law right there on that cliff. Also, all this rock's gotta be pretty hard on the horse's hooves, you know?
Easy.
What's that over there? What is that? There's a little shack over that way. I'm gonna have to check that out.
Easy, easy.
Yeah, let's head on over to the stand of trees then to see what that shack's all about. Gonna say that looks like a railway, but the rail line is way below me. It must run through the mountain. Good lord, if I can get down here. Whoa, no. Okay, there's a downgrade here I'd be able to take. Let's head on up this way. There's a shack up there I need to investigate. I don't know that I need to investigate it, but I really want to. Oh, that's pretty impressive. Nice trick, horse. May as well place a marker there. I don't know if that's the shack I was originally looking at, but it's the one I'm going to now. I just found a witch's hut? Looks like shit straight out of Skyrim, for God's sake. Oh boy, awful. Delicious. Well, that's human remains. Some delicious hair tonic. Ah, some shine. Good, I'll use that. Should I drink the mysterious liquid? Sure, why not? What could possibly go wrong? This hasn't backfired on me before. Down I go. Here's a question, what the hell just happened? Witch's Cauldron. Yes, that's exactly what that is, apparently. Yeah, and that raven just doesn't leave, apparently. You can't carry any more of this item. And don't drink any more of the cauldron, for God's sake, don't be a fool. You'll be turned into a toad next. Also, it has not stopped raining the entire time I've been up here. Madness. Madness. All those lights. Maybe I'll ride on up this road. I don't think the witch's hut was the thing I had saw, though, is the thing.
Yeah. Whoa. Good girl.
I don't even know what purpose that place served. I mean, I drank the stuff, then I passed out and just kind of... Did somebody come along and place me outside? Did they do things to me? Awful, unspeakable things. Nope, just rocks. I'm Arthur Morgan. Who the hell are you? So we're not going to get any explanation as to why he's here? No? Okay. That's cool.
Come on.
Oh, there's another hut up here. Check that one out, then. I don't even know where the hell this trail leads. Because it doesn't look like it exits anywhere. Apparently a couple of guns here. Oh no. No, no, no. No, no! Get off me, you bastard! Well, if there's a couple of bodies up here, at least we know why they're there. I'm lucky I didn't join them. Wolves are bad, man. They get you down, you're finished. Yes, I know you don't like the wolves. Hell of a spot up here. Hell of a spot. Not sure I'd want to stick around. Looks pretty dangerous. What with the witches and wolves? The only thing I can say is no one started shooting at me yet. That's a bonus. Never should have come here. Oh, hi, wolf! Oh. That was something. That was an interesting glitch. Wasn't that a great glitch? So, can I not loot this man? Oh, there's a cigarette card. Slim Grant, eh? I can't actually rob these dead fellows. However, we do have a lockbox. Ooh, nice. Got ourselves some pretty decent loot. I'll take that.
Okay, then.
Now, I wonder, the card, is that an indication as to who did this? Is Slim Grant the reason why these fellows are dead? Isn't that the corpse I'd already robbed? I'm not going to bother going down. Fairvale Shanty. I'm not going to bother checking that corpse out. Maybe I will on the way back, because it looks like I'm going to have to come back the way I came. Well, now, what have we over here? Is that a fort? Gang hideout, perhaps? Remember one way to find it? Ah, Jesus, no!
Damn it.
Damn it. I am so sorry, Beira. So terribly sorry. Why can I not feed you? Here, eat a mushroom. It'll make you feel better. I treat my horse so poorly. The loft? Is that what that's called? The loft, alright then. Oh, looks like this is the end of the road, whatever this loft place is. Question is, are the inhabitants friendly? Oh, wait. No, it's not the end of the road. So I got a ways to go yet.
Easy, easy.
No, I go, why, no. Why you do?
Yep.
Please not do, Beira. Please not do. Hell of a nice place. Is anyone home? Well, if no one's here, I'll just help myself to their things. Except, of course, I can't take their assorted biscuits because I have too many of them. I can make some more of those shotgun rounds, at least. I'll do that. I can't really make anything with my Indian tobacco yet. One more of these, though. A Next time I get into a fight, I'm gonna have to kill some folks with that. Some gun oil. Should take stock of my weapons while I'm at it. Nah, we're good. Oh boy, coffee. So what's this place a story anyway? Anyone living here? Are they all dead? It usually seems to be the case. People are usually always dead when I get to their homes. Ooh, and there's a basement! What? Is that the game's way of telling me I shouldn't go into the basement? Is the basement cursed? This is an armory down here. This is pieces of a friggin' Gatling gun there. What the hell is it? Cannonballs? Boxes of dynamite, maybe? Looks like they're manufacturing guns too here. I don't mind if I do, I'll certainly help myself to whatever I can grab, but I'm really curious and kind of afraid of what might be going on here. Also, it's still goddamn raining. Nobody home? Don't mind if I take all your things? All your apricots. Reminds me of a fun story. Years ago, back when I was still in college, I was living with this group of guys, right? And like... Wait, what's happening? Am I too warm? How can I be too warm? Yes, I'm too warm. I better switch out then. But yeah, I was living with this bunch of guys, right, back when I was in college. And yeah, as one would, we spent quite a bit of time drinking, especially on the weekends. And, so, this one particular night, we were drinking, like you do. And, for whatever reason, silly drunk talk, I suppose, the conversation twisted towards different types of fruit. And, because I think we used dried apricots for something earlier, and one of the guys was like, hey, have you ever actually seen an apricot? Like, an actual apricot? You know, like the fruit, not the dried ones. And we were discussing, I was like, no, I don't know if we ever have, really. I don't know what to say. And then the fourth guy who was up in the bathroom comes down over the stairs, and the dude who was going on and on about apricots looks at him and was like, have you ever? The other guy's like, what? Apricots! The joke was on him later when the dude who came down over the stairs, for the other guy, the apricot man's birthday, bought him a bag of fresh apricots, yelled apricots, and threw it at him. This is one of the nicest beds I've seen. So is this a bunch of guys who were planning to start a war? What is this? Like, I'd say it's something that belongs to the Lemoyne Raiders, but why would they be this far north? I asked ginseng elixir, which I don't need anymore because I'm kind of full up, thanks. Well, Beira, I don't know what this place's story is, and to be honest, I kind of don't want to know. Let's just leave. Mosey on down the trail, see where it leads. I'm amazed I haven't found any more, like, dream catchers or carvings or whatever down this way. Found a witch's hut? I suppose that's something. Also a hunting man. Excuse me, my good friend. Do you have any idea what the hell is up with the loft?
Hey, partner. Wow, must cover some ground on a horse like that.
Thank you.
Nice cloak you got.
Anyway, how's it all going for you?
Morning.
Okay, well, don't let me keep you.
Easy Howdy. Roads and kind weather, friend.
How nice of you.
Nice horse.
Not as nice as mine, though, of course, because my horse is the best. My horse is the greatest! The best around. All these trees are leaning weird. The best. Na 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 na. Ah, yes, the weird mechanical screech of an elk. Oh, hello, what's that? Oh, hey, a corpse. Oh, this actually does come all the way down this way. Oh, well, whatever. I guess I'm just going to explore this area. After that, though, I don't think I'm going to explore the other section of Grizzlies.
There we go.
What the hell is this place? Cougar? Cougar? Okay, so I need to kill cougars with a bow. Sounds like there's one nearby somewhere. Like a school or an observatory or something? What the hell is this? I don't know if I'm gonna take no for an answer on this. I need to get inside this place. I gotta see what the hell's going on. And why the music got all spooky all of a sudden. Oh boy, wintergreen. Like something friggin' Tesla would invent. What is this? Can I not climb the ladder? Okay, no, I can't. I just was looking at the wrong side of it. This is goddamn spooky, is what it is. Can I not do this? Okay then. Is this something I'm gonna have to come back to later? Is there some sort of bizarre mission that's going to involve this place? Can I climb in through the windows? I mean, I probably need to destroy a window to do that, but this one seems to be a likely candidate. Ah, hell, you know what? If you want to destroy stuff, nah, the window's not big enough for me to crawl in. What the hell is going on in here? It's like a laboratory of some kind. I suppose I can't use my lockbreaker to get inside either. I don't even know how to equip the goddamn thing. It used to be in my item wheel, but now it's not. Whatever. I'll leave it alone for now. I'll have to come back to it later, under the presumption that there is something to do here. Let's check out that little building then. See if there's anything of note there. It's just a water tower. Nothing fancy.
So
might be something on top of it, though. Let's investigate. And the answer is no. No, there's not. Alley-oop! Oh, crap!
Okay, my girl.
I may have misjudged that jump. There's a couple of bodies over there, I guarantee this is goddamn Mumfreys again. Probably check that out. Let's check out this other thing first, though. Whatever it may be.
Okay, there.
Brandywine Drop Station House. Doesn't really look like it's been used in a while. Thought this old trading post on Roanoke Ridge was kind of interesting. Thus I drew a picture of it. I still love the fact that Arthur is just this budding artist. In a different life, he might have made himself quite the, you know, noteworthy artist. Instead, he is an outlaw. And his only art is shooting people in the head. Cigarette card. Thank you. Isabel Barlow, that's some damn fine hair she's got. Good lord, I only have four of those? Good lord. I'm never going to finish any of these sets, holy shit. Yeah, what is Dover Hill? What the hell is that place? I'll go investigate this other building down here, I guess. And then I'll go check out the corpses. Yep. Corpses! I'm gonna get some corpses.
Hey there, mister.
Something tells me I should have stayed up that way.
Easy now.
Hello, does anybody live here? Or is this going to be another sad tale of a bunch of murdered folk?
What the hell?
Oh, what? What the flying fuck happened here? What happened to these people? Got that bomb go off? Holy shit! I mean, I'll still take their hair pomade, but what happened to you folks? Good lord, they've gone in pieces. No shit. They got hit by a meteorite. What are the odds? It looks like it's at least three people. What were they, just sat around to dinner or something, and then all of a sudden they got hit by a goddamn rock from space? That's pretty insane, that is. I'll leave you to your smoldering remains. And I'll take this meteorite and do something with it. Meteor house. This house seemed to have been struck by something. A meteor, maybe. I find it interesting that Arthur even knows what a meteor is. A piece of a meteoroid can be sold for cash. I can apparently carry up to three of those things? Where the hell would I find more? How frequently does this place get struck by meteors? Also, I got so distracted by that, I'm pretty sure there's a cigarette card in there. Did I actually pick it up? No, I didn't. Okay. Another gem of beauty. Hattie Langry. The bizarre things you see in this game, like, I would not have expected to see a group of folk who've been murdered by a meteorite. Of course, then again, I did say that I apparently missed an instance of a UFO, so, you know, stranger things, I guess. I'm sure there must be an easier way down. Oh, that's an interesting lean-to they've built for the rails. Good way to stop it from falling victim to a rock slide or something. Speaking of rocks, is there anything of note underneath it? Don't look like it.
Easy, whoa.
Alright, let's go investigate those bodies. See what happened to them. Bunch of inbred hicks is my best guess. No, you don't. I better get behind some cover. Goddamn Mumfreys.
Your mama ain't gonna find you in the grave out here!
These sorry bastards are pretty prevalent up this way. Also, while it's certainly possible that that lady over there owns that doll, the fact that there's a doll there is kinda sketchy. I don't even want to think about what might have happened here. I'll be a nice guy and not rob the people they've murdered. Well, now that I've done that, let's follow this trail.
Okay, girl. Yep.
Let's go along the cliff face though, next to the waterfalls.
Yep.
Beautiful spot for a picnic. Maybe a beautiful spot to die too, who knows. What are these things? I don't know if I've picked them yet. Ooh. Violet snowdrop. If I had picked them, I haven't seen very many. Violent snowdrop. And that's more stuff, but I can't be bothered to get off my horse anymore. God damn, that's picturesque. What legendary animal lives here? Moose! Legendary moose! Well, hot damn. Seeing as I'm here, I may as well kill that. I'm carrying a pile of wolf pelts that are probably... they're probably dubious in quality now, so...
Yeah. Whoa,
yeah. Is that it? No, it can't be. Prior to tracking that moose though, what's going on over here? Is there anything of note on this little island? Yes, there is actually.
Easy.
By anything of note, apparently I mean... I'm going to track this moose now.
We got a trail. This could take a while.
I guarantee you I'm going to need something heavy duty to take this thing out, so let's take my rolling block, probably. And our clue up here as to where the damn thing went. Ah yes, shit.
Ain't close.
That way. I'm a coming for you, you large antlered bastard! I ever tell you I've actually run across several moose? It's not exactly an uncommon thing around here. In the middle of the city, you'll have one walk up to a storefront just out of nowhere. That's also not really bullshit, because that happened to a friend of mine.
Must be near.
She was working and she happened to be standing at the counter, like, doing something there, and then she kind of got this feeling of being watched, and she looked up, and there was a moose just staring her in the face, just in the window. Because, you know, Newfoundland, that's how it is around here. I walked headlong into one once when I was walking through the woods. I mean, literally, I headbutted the damn thing. If not for the fact that I confused it, it might have mauled me. Oh, that's it there. Hello, moose friend. Is a bow with an improved arrow for clean kill? Hi. Holy shit, look at the size of this thing! Also, there's another question mark? Oh, it's just... that's the legendary animal territory. See, that's the thing, as ridiculous as they look, moose are big goddamn scary animals. Take it from me, I know what I'm talking about. Oh, it's dead. Yeah, you stand next to one of these things and you feel incredibly insignificant. Granted, this is much bigger than any moose I've personally ever seen, but still. I'm not a small guy. And, yeah, the moose I ran into that time was much bigger than I am. Although he looks all kind of sad and tiny. Without his skin. As I'm sure we all would. Well, I'm gonna have to put my exploration to an end. I need to go see the trapper. And then probably the fence. And then after that, I was gonna go a cougar hunting. But, I might save that for another day. I'll probably just go ahead and do a mission before I stop. Because, I don't know, I'm at like 2.5 hours there now. That's pretty long. So I should probably stop soon. Hell of a way to spend a sick day. Hunting critters. Please don't get hit by a train. That would suck like you wouldn't believe. I will go over and investigate Willard's rest before I ride south, though. Hello, Beira. Here you go. No doubt there's a bunch of stuff that I've missed, but, them's the breaks. That's a bear. That was probably a snake. That's a mighty impressive cliff. So I have a question. Is anybody home? I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say no. Which reminds me, I've been back to Downs Ranch ever since I discovered Mr. Downs had died. The place is deserted. Well, I mean, you know, and when I collected the debt from his wife, she and their son was leaving. Were leaving, I should say. Grammar. My grammar is atrocious tonight. But there's nobody there anymore. pitchfork. Can I go inside the house though? That'd be nice. Yeah, I don't understand why I can't access my, lock breaker anymore. Like, is that something I need to take off my horse? I don't know, let's find out. Because it's like hats and horse care and all that jazz. I know I own one, where the hell is it? You know what? Don't care. Do not care at all. Go have a chat with the trapper. Means I gotta go on down yonder again.
Yep.
Although first...
Solo.
I don't know, this looks like something that might be important. Except, of course, it isn't, because why would it be? Of course, then again, it behooves me to check behind the... I found a legendary fish location, too, eh? Something tells me I'd have to make room on the back of my horse for this thing, though, so I won't bother catching it yet. I am quite honestly shocked that there's nothing of note behind this waterfall. Truly, truly, deeply shocked. I would think there would be something here, at least. But alas, I am mistaken, it seems. Well, enough screwing around. Let's go back to the trapper. Sell him this moose. Hello, who are you?
Easy now.
I think the horse was about to buck me off. Hello, cougar. Goodbye, cougar. Well, that's good. I need to kill some of you guys anyway. I need cougar pelts for the final upgrade in the camp, which is Arthur's clothing chest. Yeah, I think I jumped off just as I got bucked off the horse, so... Lucked out there. Yeah, I'll have to remember to keep this cougar pelt when I sell a bunch of stuff to the guy. There's a bear nearby, too, by the sounds of it. I got no beef with the bear. The bear can live. The bear may live, the cougar may die. Well, not may, it kind of is already dead now, isn't it?
Hey, mister!
Got a whole bunch of shit to sell to the trapper now, though I don't know how well the wolf pelts have held up. I wonder how much a meteorite is even worth, anyway. What's the going price for a meteorite?
Hey there, mister!
Oh, guaranteed, that's another goddamn wolf. Ignore it. Wait. What the hell are you? Oh shit. Not like this. Not like this. Who the hell was that? He sicked a wolf on me by the looks of it. Come on, Beira. It's over. Get back up here. You got more pelts you need to pick up. I think you still got all the... Yeah, you still have the wolf pelts on you. Yeah, see who the hell that guy was. Let's see if I can track him down. How do I look strange? You wanna see strange, you see the guy who just called a wolf on me. The friggin' Beastmaster just tried to kill me.
Yep.
Who the hell was that? So whoever he is, he ran down this way. Of course, I can't track people as well as I can track animals, though he seemed more beast than man.
Easy, easy.
Hang out here for a minute, Beira. An old tomb, eh? Did he come in here? Who were these fellas? I know I was joking about Skyrim earlier, but this looks a hell of a lot like a Draugr burial mound. Lot of dead folk. Hello! What's this? I have a Viking hatchet. That's cool. So this place is going to warrant some further investigation. Is the hatchet the only thing here? Yeah, this is the way I came in, I think. I can be a pirate and a Viking! This is amazing! Fuck. Yes. Is this where the Wolfman went, though? I don't know. So what the hell is a Viking burial ground doing here? Like, this is north of what would be in, you know, the real world, Louisiana, so what the hell is a Viking burial mound doing here? Where the hell did that wolfman go? I don't really have time to be looking for him right now. If he wasn't there, I don't know where the hell he would have been. I might have to go hunting for him at a later date. I'll just have to remember he was near the Viking burial ground. I don't know what I can do to make Arthur look like a Viking. Aside from the helmet, of course. I mean, I can dress him in thick furs and stuff, but the problem with that is, it's kinda not going to be very, fitting, considering I'm down south at the moment. Perhaps if we end up having to go north again at any given point, it'll work out a bit better. It's another weird shaped tree. Can I sketch a picture of this one? Yes, I can. Cool. Nice. I haven't continued the story too much, but holy crap, if I found a lot of weird things. Oh, that trail tree is actually pretty close to this one. Do they mean anything? I don't know. Very curious. Hello, my trapper friend. I have been on one hell of an adventure. You wouldn't believe the things I've seen.
Leather, fur, you name it, I can work with it.
Welcome back, sir. So, what do you have for me?
Oh,
let's see.
No idea what I have for you.
Done.
I've killed so many wolves. Oh wait, no, I can't sell that. I need that.
Once in a lifetime, eh?
Real good doing business.
No kid.
Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work.
So what can I make with the legendary moose thing? Legendary moose hunting jacket. I can't really make that right now though, because it's a bit too warm. Damn fine coat, though. Alright, well, I guess I'll ride down into Rhodes and perhaps stop in to see the fence while I'm at it. Well, I don't know, it's one hell of a long ride. Maybe I'm better off going to Emerald Ranch and taking the train. Or a stagecoach or something.
Thanks, partner.
Then again, maybe not. I don't know, who cares?
Look out!
I wonder if the Viking helmet adds any more protection against headshots. That'd be interesting. Like, you hear a bullet go ping when it hits you in the head. I'd stop in that camp, but I know who it is. It's a Mexican fella who's really nice and warns me about the pig farm, which not that big of a deal anymore, seeing as I've killed the folks at the pig farm. Bunch of incestuous, possibly cannibalistic jerks that they are. Yeah, I think I'll go do that last mission. Do that mission for Micah, asshole that he is, and that'll be it for tonight. It's been an interesting round of Red Dead, though. So many things that I've found. So many weird, glorious things. Seamus, I have more business for you.
Hello again.
Yeah, I guess I'll sell you that. $30 for a meteorite? Come on, now I'd expect more. I think I'll hang on to it for now, then.
You're back. Alright, take a look. Got a little kick show in mind, huh?
What does this do? Health experience bonus. It's not really of much use to me anymore, because my health is as high as it can get, but alright. Da 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 da. Yeah, screw it. It's just about to ride all the way down there myself. To be honest, it's probably just as fast because I'm still gonna have to go through the travel screen, regardless of whether I take a stagecoach or a train or whatever. It's just about to fly arrow straight down. Whatever it is Micah's got going on for us, know that it's going to be violent, so at the very least it'll give me a chance to use my fancy new hatchet. Appears I trampled something, I know not what. Not really important at the moment. Looks like a group of Lemoyne raiders. It's okay, I'll leave them alone for now. I don't want any distractions. Know why I thought there'd be something interesting here. Here's I was mistaken. Yeah, that over there is probably those two dongs who I can sell horses to.
Good girl. Easy.
Could have sworn I heard voices. Maybe it was a guy riding by that I didn't see. I have got to stop trying to murder my horse. You need to eat. You need to eat because I've done terrible things too.
Okay, my
good. I'm sure that'll cure the brain damage. You eat your oat cakes.
Who goes there?
It's me.
Good to see you back on one feet.
Now let me tell you boys a story. And when old uncle was just a little boy, back when they called me nephew, I guess, not uncle. My real uncle, Uncle Jeb, my mother's brother's cousin, he was kind of funny. One of those men you didn't want to be left alone with on account of him doing, well, you know what I mean, not right with young men. Anyways, he wanted to take me fishing. Now, I didn't want to go, because if there's one place men act funny, it's around fish.
I think I've already heard this story.
Anyways, he tried to take me.
Also, the captioning is way off.
Mr. Morgan. I sent my brother's friend Ned instead. I never liked Ned much either. I figured, well, they could do the damnedest to each other.
You know, Arthur, I can always make you a new set.
I need a perfect buck pelt, and I need a perfect panther pelt, wherever the hell I'm going to find that. And I need one more cougar pelt.
Thanks, Mr. Pearson.
But in the moment, I've seen grown men piss themselves. I am talking a puddle of piss, all because of the way he looked at him. And this was one of them. This big, tough bastard just gives this look. You know, one of those I'm about to explode moments. I thought we'd be counting corpses in minutes. Only Javier here, get this, Javier just gives one look. And the bastard turns to jelly.
Well, next time then, you boys bring me.
Yeah, I want to live. One hothead is enough. Excuse me.
Literally, a puddle of piss.
I just want to see it the once.
That's all it takes.
Aye? What's this about puddles and piss?
You did good with that Gray's business.
Like I told you, I was born and down in manor houses.
What the hell are you wearing?
I'm a Viking, don't question it. Okay? Let's just be cool. How are you doing hanging out next to Dutch's tent? Burke? Well, it's just well to see what he wants, I guess, before I carry on. Well, before I stop, I should say. How may this Viking help you? It will be a glorious day to die!
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you and me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little. Pearson! Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch. You tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I mean... I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town, and things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a cornered tiger.
Sure thing.
Anyway, somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Colm O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight. Wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parley? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap. You shoot a lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance you gotta take.
I killed Colm's brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I loved dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
It's a time for Vikings!
Fine.
Mount up then, Morgan. Let's go then.
It's a good thing we're doing this at daybreak. Perfect time of the day to do a damn fool thing that might get us all killed. Got all the shooting out of the way, so I got the rest of the day off.
You know, I've been fighting Colm for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
And you're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Well, maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? We had Pinkertons coming after us.
Because of Blackwater.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll.
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look. You ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover us, hmm?
Okay. Just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I.
Funny, considering Dutch not too long ago said something about the fact that he knew he was going to... I was going to betray him eventually, and he said the same thing to Javier not too long ago, too. Also, the thing I was going to comment...
Up there! Men on the ridge!
Oh, Driscoll's, from the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big. Caring too much. That's my problem.
I call bullshit.
There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Colm O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all. That might be nonsense, too.
Seems like it so far.
It's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
Yeah, despite all the antagonism between...
You're gonna peel off up ahead.
Okay.
We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot.
That's how you spell plain.
Where you can keep an eye on things.
All right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Yeah, Bill antagonizes Javier quite a bit, but he seems like he was talking up how goddamn terrifying Javier could be earlier, and, like, praising it as a good thing. It goes a long way to explain how they're friends later. They're still friends later, I should say, why Javier covers for Bill when he flees to Mexico. Speaking of, I think this is not too far from where I, not too far from where I had to rescue Bill from Bounty Hunters.
There we go.
That's rather portentous, isn't it? The dead animal. Nice wide open area. Ah, it's next to the wrecked oil derrick. Not a lot of cover. Are we going to finally see Colm? I only saw him from afar last time, and I guess that's what I'm doing now. Oh, there he is.
Hello, Dutch.
Interesting that I can hear him.
Sure. So, how's your gang doing? They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world. How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader.
He dresses almost as fancy as Dutch.
A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us.
That helmet's in trouble. With a bullet hole on us.
They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here, Colm? Is this thing over?
Oh, crap. Nice broken nose you got there, Colm. I think I might have gotten into a lot more than I thought.
Hello, sugar. You ain't dead, is you? Not yet, anyway.
Hands off the helmet. That's mine.
I don't know. Colm's got a sense.
Handing him over to the lords. I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella, Colm's right, we can draw them all back.
True. Where'd Colm and Patrick head off to?
In a town, I think.
He's escaping! Shoot him! Relax! I got him.
Crap.
Did I kill you?
Oh, not yet.
No, of course not. Not yet. But I will.
Well, that didn't work. So how am I supposed to escape? Wait, I'm not dead yet? Oh, Jesus, what's happening? How did they know I was up there? Unless Micah had something to do with it, I wouldn't be surprised, bastard that he is. Don't go shooting a Viking.
Finally. Put his weapons over there!
I'm shocked I'm not dead yet. Hello, Colm. Where the hell are we? One of the many hideouts you assholes own that I destroyed?
Uh,
Arthur Morgan. It's good to see you.
Hello, Colm.
How's the wound?
I hardly feel it.
God, this is hard to look at.
Septic, ain't nice. Now, tell me. Fine gun like you. Why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Colm.
No. It's Dutch's famous charisma.
Charisma, you say?
A whole bunch of my boys. Six-point cabin.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached true.
Let me go, Colm, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it, they get him. They forget about me.
Seems unlikely.
Ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. But see, we lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
You only met with him to grab me?
Of course. He's gonna be so mad. He's gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Oh, Arthur. Arthur. I missed you.
I can tell. That's got to be dreadfully uncomfortable. So how the hell am I getting out of this? This is a lot more involved than I was expecting. Cool. Here I am in my undies. It's a good thing I've got abs of steel. Took my helmet, took my hatchet. Oh, they shot me in the shoulder with a goddamn shotgun, it looks like. Cauterize the wound. Yep. Well, this is pretty rough.
Shut your hole. I don't want to go to Mexico. I want to go home. Home. Hold on, I'll be back in a minute. What the hell?
You have a gun. I want it. Well, I can't get his gun?
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. You better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
Where am I? Can I see where I am? Oh, I'm all the way down here. Oh, there's my horse and my weapons. Okay, I better try to go back for that shit then. better not get spotted though. I get spotted, I'm fucked. If I can stealth kill a lot of these bastards, that'd be nice. Like this lad, for example.
What's going on here? You're supposed to be.
I hit him clean in the back with that. I don't know how that worked. I hit the tree? How did I hit the tree? Doesn't make a lot of sense. Did it just phase through his back and hit the tree? What? I suppose all my food and stuff is gone too. Alright then.
God damn it, how hard is it to hold a prison? It's your last round.
Well, looks like stealth is not an option anymore. Oh God. Let's get my shit and get out of here. I'm pretty sure this is where I came across, pretty sure this is where I came across some, you know, asshole guy, Micah at one point. There. Let's get on my horse and get the hell out of here. What? Random dead blue jay? Turn to Clemens Point. Okay, then. Oh, shit. I'm probably gonna have to do this guns blazing. I'm not one for stealth. Of course, my aim is way off. My aim is way off on account of the fact that, well, you know, I'm kind of dying, I think. I suppose I should count myself thankful they didn't kill my horse. Okay, and then I pass out. Hopefully the horse knows the way. I think she does. The important thing is I didn't fall off. Oh look, I'm upright again. Hey look, there's the old mill. Hi. Is that Sean spazzing out in the background? I think it is. I'm okay. This...
I told you it was a setup, Dutch. My boy, my dear boy, what? They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help. Reverend Swanson.
He's gonna set the law on us. No, oh, of course he was.
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan,
you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur.
Okay. I got you.
You're safe now.
That's pretty, Dutch. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
This weird red filter will disappear in a moment's notice. I shall dream of deer. I shall become one with them. I shall become a buck in my next life. A few weeks later. Okay then, well I suppose it takes a while to recover from what just happened to me. Am I wearing the helmet? I am!
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, River.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
My Viking strength will get me through. Shoulder's gonna hurt like a son of a bitch for a while. Blessed are the peacemakers, which is the inscription on a certain fellow's grave. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to check that now then, I guess. Let's see, what exactly are the things I would have need to do to get past that? I'm missing a single stranger, and I've only got two bounties left. No, I think it's... yeah, story. I gotta go in story for the missions. Oh, chapter 3. I'm in chapter 3 now. Oh wait, no, I was always in chapter 3. Doi. Because that was after we got run out of Valentine. Free yourself from perform self-surgery within 1 minute. Kill the O'Driscoll gang members that beat and shot you. Done that. Escape O'Driscoll's camp without being spotted. Yeah, I couldn't do that. Trail tree! Legendary moose! About how I got killed, or nearly. I have been recuperating after an interesting encounter with Colm O'Driscoll. Dutch got it into his mind to meet the bastard, to somehow end all this lunacy. Only Colm did not share Dutch's sense of honor amongst thieves. The whole thing was set up to kidnap me, then lure all the rest of us into a trap so we can get arrested and Colm could disappear away. Us somehow carrying off his sin. Along with our own to the gallows. Seems like Colm is enjoying this modern world even less than we are. More by luck than judgment, I escaped and somehow got back here, more dead than alive, and collapsed into bed for a few feverish days. After much nursing from Miss Grimshaw and Miss Tilly and much guilt-ridden apologies from Dutch over his stupidity, I survived okay. My shoulder where I was shot ain't come down with gangrene, and I will live, if even uglier than before. This is getting even more insane. Things is getting even more insane with the local population. My sense is neither the Greys nor the Braithwaites have a pot to piss in, but I ain't spent too much time with the landed gentry. Whatever else they is, they don't make one believe in the nobility of the aristocracy. But you must believe in the might of the Vikings. Ah, look, I have to go do something with Bill.
There she is.
I don't know about that get-up, Arthur.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
But I'm a Viking. Everyone loves Vikings.
Hey, Mary Beth.
Glad to see you back on your feet.
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Sure thing.
How are you, Tilly?
How are you, more to the point? Feeling better?
Yeah, I'll live. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Yes. See you later.
Miss Grimshaw?
Ah, you're looking much better. I was worried.
Yeah, I'm fine.
And then she walks away from me. Is somebody stumbling drunk in the woods? No, that's just Lenny tripping up on a twig.
Hey, Abigail.
How are you feeling?
I'll live. Well, I should get back to it.
Yeah, goodbye.
Get back to nothing, because that's more than enough of this. I was not expecting that mission to go. I suppose it's entirely accurate that Micah had us do some damn fool thing, but I didn't assume it was a damn fool thing that was going to nearly get me killed. Anyway, that's quite enough of this for one night. If you happen to stop by to watch, I thank you very, very much for doing so, and well, hopefully I'll see you fine folks next time, when I will be doing something new, I think. Maybe. I don't know, I haven't decided yet. But, I'm either going to do something entirely new that I've been planning on doing for a while, or I'm going to carry on with something I started ages ago, and have not played in months. So, whatever it may be, hopefully you'll join me for that. Until then, however, I'm going to wish you a farewell, and a good night.